guy.
Maybe we should have it like that.
Yeah.
No, it's not gonna
happen. Okay, there we go. We're live. Okay, we're waiting for people. It's building an audience. We're gonna go live here. Come on. This is what I hate. The live thing sucks sometimes. It takes forever.
Wait, 1 second.
Oh, there we go. Okay, here we go. We got a person in here.
Okay.
Yeah, this is us just messing around.
I know.
Jeff.
What happened is that I was going crazy with the freaking trailer.
There we go.
I'm 98% finished with the trailer. It turned out amazing.
Okay.
I'm just doing like little small edits.
Okay. Hey guys. We're gonna be on live. We're gonna get his phone up. Let's get his phone running now. Go ahead and you can do yours. Yeah, this is a little crazy right now, so give us a second. We've been busy all day editing our new trailer for Revenant Acres. It's amazing. So give us a minute. This is why we're late. We're usually never late. Hey, Jeff. Okay, guys. We're waiting for him. Hey, Drew. Thanks, Drew. Be nice. Okay, here we go. We got another camera going. This is awesome.
Okay. All right, here we go.
Okay. She's got hers going. We got Jen getting up.
Okay.
I can't even see you right now. Okay, guys. Marcus, Matt, and, well, you can't see. Jen is over to the side. Move over a little bit, Matt. Let's see if we can get all each other in here. Move over. Come on. Okay. Yeah, we're kind of squished right now, honestly. For you guys at home, we are coming to you live from our apartment for questions that we're going to answer for you guys. We're actually filming it right now. We have two cameras right now on. Hey, JR. For all you guys who have questions about the paranormal, the episodes we film, just general questions, ask. We want to have you guys ask. We want to know what you guys have on your mind. And I'm getting really, I'm getting like, ooh.
Oh, yeah. Let's all go back. All of us go back because then we're in, actually have room now.
Yeah. Okay. Come on, guys. Oh, thank. Thank you. Marcato. That, yeah, I work with him. Okay. Go ahead, guys. Yes, and Wonder Woman is here. Q&A, ask.
Q&A.
We're waiting.
Hi, Julie.
We're really squished right now. It's uncomfortable. Anybody prepared to ask? Go ahead. Hey, JR. Hey, man. It's just a question and answer right now. Go ahead and start typing your questions in. Anybody and everybody. We want to know. I am really squished, and I'm getting home, and I'm getting really, claustrophobic right now. Everybody move, spread out. Okay, let's see what we got here. I love you too, Drew. You know, no one's gonna ask a question, I can guarantee it.
Yeah, Marcus, tell us all your secrets.
I have no secrets, none, I promise.
I don't know if that's true.
No secrets, Jeff. I share everything with everybody.
Just kidding.
I don't know why it's saying my connection is weak and yours is not. We're on the same Wi-Fi network.
Because I have Samsung Galaxy S7, man.
Yeah, I know. I can see that. Well, you have 2 viewers and I have 8 viewers and she hasn't set hers yet. So we're going to do that. We're going to put another one on the table here. Jeez. We're going to do 3 of them now. So this is going to be a little nuts right here. Yeah, well, holy crap.
Let's go back because then we all get into the shot.
This is really weird. Okay, now this is going to be really...
Drew,
what did I tell you? Be nice.
Do you believe people are scratched in certain locations?
Okay.
Usually.
Well, okay, we got one question now. We have to answer this, so hold on, people. Go ahead.
Okay.
Who's this from?
This is from Julie. Do you believe people get scratched in certain locations? Well, it... usually isn't the location itself, it's usually the entity. And the entity is the reason why people get scratched. Negative entities. Yeah. And yes, I believe that there's a lot of varieties of what spirits can do. Even usually it's the demons that like to do the scratching, but there's also negative human spirits that can scratch. So it's not really particularly the location, it's more like the entity, is my belief.
And my belief is, again, it... what he just said, and sometimes it'll, if it is an entity, and let's say somebody provokes before you go in, and it sees someone as a weaker, personality, maybe, it'll go after them, and, So honestly, it's not the location, it's just what happens that day, you know. And honestly, it happens at different locations, different times, different people. So it usually gets the weaker one. Okay, so here we go. We have another question. What is it? I can't read it. It says, my question is, how many people
you're welcome
you have working with you or doing this all together? Okay. Want to go ahead?
Oh,
I'll let you go ahead.
Okay, okay. Sorry. I got another question. Oh, wait. What was that question? My question
right here,
is
right here. Richard S.
How many people have you worked or are you working with? Or are you doing this all together? Yeah. Right now, it is Marcus and I really working together because we have something in common. We're both filmmakers. We both enjoy what we do. We have a big passion for this. I was editing like a madman today. He was here.
I was watching it.
Yes, he was helping me out with certain ideas, but it was crazy. And so what we decided to do is put Paranormal Films and Paranormal Research Unit together. And Marcus and I are both lead investigators, and we're going to pretty much all over the states to investigate certain locations. Yeah. And we're creating full-length episodes. They'll be featured on both channels, Paranormal Research Unit and Paranormal Films. And right now, I'm editing Revenant Anchors, and he's going to edit Rhodes Hotel.
So two coming out at the same time, so it's going to be a little crazy right now.
Yes.
We're going to be a little busy. So now, I just saw Jeff ask the question, what is the craziest thing that happened at Revenant Anchors?
Oh my God!
That is a question! I'll go first.
Okay.
I'll go first. To me, and I did not get to see this footage yet, what me and Matt did, we split up. I went to the top floor, he was on the bottom floor, and stuff started going crazy. He was down there, and I can say for the first time that he was speaking Latin. Were you speaking Latin?
Yeah,
down
I was
there?
Speaking Latin to this entity because apparently there's a demonic entity there. I haven't really done the whole Latin thing. I want to see if it affected it in some way because that's what, you know, priests do and some other Christian religions. They like the, you know, other dominations of religions speak in Latin to provoke these demonic entities. So I tried it out. It seemed like it worked.
And it worked. And guess where it went? It went up to me.
Yeah.
It ran upstairs, and when you watch the episode, you'll see my demeanor change. I actually got to watch some of this today. It was crazy.
I was acting different.
Oh, and I would also say the big thing is when it's completely dark out there, mm-hmm. you cannot see the building.
Yes.
That's one of the craziest things that happened there. It was just, we couldn't find it. And it just kind of popped up out of nowhere. So that's a good one.
Yeah.
Go over here.
So Ulysses asked a question.
And that was Jeff Fent, by the way. We forgot to say
yes,
his name.
Jeff Fent. Well, thanks for the question. So for Ulysses, Matt Benton, when is the first episode of Man vs. Paranormal supposed to come out? Well, I decided to not do episodes for this, or at least not right now. I decided to actually make a full feature documentary and put it into some film festivals. So what I'm doing is one big location for 3 nights. Shoot, this is giving out details about this.
Shh, don't give them too much. Just, you're done.
Okay.
You're done.
For 3 nights, I'll be there. That's all I can really say. There's a little details about it that is different than any show and different than any web series and different than any full feature film ever done. What I'm going to be doing is going to be making paranormal history. So that's all I can really say.
Okay, so Matt, what we're going with is I need to go into detail about what happened with Man vs. Paranormal. Randolph County Infirmary, his hard drive died. Like, literally is dead. Nothing came off of it. So he lost every single bit of evidence he had. So he's waiting to start over again. That's why we're joining everything.
You get kicked down, you get back up.
Dale! September 17th, you gotta come to my hometown. Dude, I wish I could. I'm gonna be in Indiana that day, honestly. I will be going to a couple spots and we're investigating Thornhaven that day. Sorry, man. I'll come the next week. Okay. We need to look at another one. What's the next question?
Boys, Ulysses says, thanks for answering my question. Hope you are doing well, dude. Thank you. And we all miss you here in Temecula.
Thank you. You're missed. Okay, here we go.
But I'll come back for a visit. I don't know when. I have to focus my money on this documentary, so don't know.
Everything costs money.
Yes.
Here we go. We got Jared Frank.
What's up, Matt? Y'all should come to Providence so I can go on an investigation with you, but
well,
the money and transportation. We'll get there. We will come out when we can. Mm-hmm. We always promise you guys stuff that we will fulfill. It might take some time, but we will come where we say we will. So don't worry. We'll be down there.
I've investigated so much of California and Nevada and Arizona. And now I move to the east for the specific reason of investigating asylums and jails and stuff like that. That's the reason why I moved down here, to expand my research and not just the west. And now I want to see what if entities are different in the, what?
He just keeps going.
Just want to see if entities are a little bit different over here.
I am, like, squished.
I've never done asylums before until I moved down here, so that's pretty cool.
Okay, here we go. We got Eric Smith. I need to see this. Bitches from Olivia. Yes, we are. Okay. Angie Petrella. I haven't seen you forever. Come with me to Fox Hollow Farm on the 22nd. Tickets went on sale today. That is, what day is that?
Okay, you say tickets. How many people are going to be there, though?
What day of the week is that? I don't even know.
22nd, it's like, well, that's in 12 days from now, so.
So 12 days from now is what, Friday?
Today is Saturday, so.
What? I don't know what the day, hold on, is. We'll figure it out. I'll let you know. I'll let you know. Eric, we finally get to meet at Willow's Weeps. Yes, dude. We will get to meet you. Finally, we will meet you. Olivia, Lana, Banana, and I miss you. We miss you too. We all miss you guys. Okay, I know you both are brave. This is from Jeff. I know you both are brave, but there is a place that freaked you out. Both freaked out. We have to answer this. Hold on, I gotta spread out because I'm like squished. Okay. I got two places. I'm gonna let Jen speak up. Okay. Look in the camera right there. Speak up.
They have a super.
There we go.
Super hair. And up here too. Heaven.
Saddamsville?
First heaven. Derby. And Revenant.
Revenant Acres. Revenant Acres.
First one. They're talking different. If we have a plan, we're fucking. They're trying to fucking keep it happening.
Well, apparently, one of our mics just ran out of battery. So, we're going to unplug it real quick. I just looked at it, and we just ran out of battery. Go ahead, second place. Go ahead.
Number two.
This is from Jeff right here.
Okay.
We have that. Luckily, we have that mic going.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah.
Good thing we had a backup plan.
Yeah, this happens all the time.
Oh, there's another question.
Saddamsville or Revenant Acres?
Pillow attack.
Oh, at RCI. Randolph County Infirmary. Yeah, that was crazy. Okay, now let's. Okay, we have. Hold on.
Question.
We have another question. Let's go down this side now.
Okay, another question. Would you guys ever do an investigation in another country like Mexico or Canada? Well, there is quite a few in England and Scotland that I want to go to. There's a few castles. I want to go to Ancient Ram Inn. There's so many locations out there. Pavalia is another big one I want to go to.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We all want to go to Pavalia.
I know, right?
All of us.
Any paranormal investigator doesn't want to go.
It's a freaking island, man. I mean, come on.
Island of death, literally.
Literally the island of death. We all want to go there. We'll get there someday.
But it's expensive. Out of country is way more expensive than because you have to pay for plane ticket and everything. Even in different countries, you probably have problems with communication, which is like in Italy. I don't know Italian at all when it comes to their language. So, yeah.
Okay, so now I have to answer some of this one. October 27th and October 22nd. I'm going to message you, Angie. What? That's our anniversary. I forgot. She reminded me. She said, no, you talk to her. You talk to her. Eric Smith says, Marcus, you've got to come. Oh, dude, I'll be on your radio show, Eric, any day of the week.
Me too.
Did the haunted brick do that?
Okay. Speaking of haunted bricks.
what, Marcus? What's up? Okay, come on, keep the questions coming. What do we have here? Okay, come on, guys, ask some questions. I know, look, he wants to go too. We got Sean from EVP. Yeah, so if she says yes, we will come. It's up to her. Not me. I want to go. I want to go really bad. Yes, and I am squeamish, Olivia. I have very bad anxiety to being, you know, yeah. I feel kind of squished right now.
Come on. I feel like we need to move these back for
us. I know. I feel like we just need to separate. Jesus Christ.
Okay, so what's another? Okay. Any more questions, people? Like, you could ask anything.
Hold on. He asked a question and I missed it.
Okay.
Where is it? I'm trying to find it. There it is. Oh! There we go. I got it.
Yeah. Okay,
Sean, we took a picture. We actually went to go. I picked him up. We drove back, and on the way back, we stopped at Mansfield, and we're just taking pictures. We want to go there.
Yeah.
We have to go there, but it's really, for all those who don't know, it's like $1,200 or something like that. We want to go. We want to go there next year. So if it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, it doesn't.
It's expensive.
It's expensive. Yeah, so there you go. That's from Sean. So now we know who.
I know both. Okay. Yeah. Wait. I know the both. Wasn't there one about fear that freaks you out? Yeah, there's one.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Should we answer that one?
Yeah, we haven't answered that one.
She answered that one.
Oh, okay.
We never answered that one.
Yeah, I know. We didn't answer those. That's a good question, Jeff. I think it was from Jeff, right? That asked that question. When can
Hold on. Okay, is that TV media sci-fi offered you to be part of Haunted? Yes.
Do an audition with sci-fi. I believe it's sci-fi.
Look
it's
at
Pilgrim
her.
Studios.
Talk. She'll talk. She's going to sign for it. Tell her what you're saying.
Oh, okay. So I did do a audition for Pilgrim Studios, but the problem is with Pilgrim Studios is that they are known to fake evidence, so if they make me fake evidence, I'm not going with the plan that they want to do. So, yeah, it's just a maybe, too. I did do an audition, though.
Yeah. Good. Okay, so now I'm going to answer the fear one.
Okay.
From Jeff. That's a location that has scared me the most out of my mind is Saddamsville. That's the only place I've been really, really scared. Saddamsville is the only place I've been really, really, really scared. Had stuff follow me home. I got scratched there. I got something thrown at me there.
I've had this experience where things were thrown.
So that's the scariest place for me, Jeff. You know this already. What's yours?
That's a hard one. Being scared. Well, I can't say too much because it reveals information about what I'm doing for Man vs. Paranormal. But let's just say I was alone in a certain area of the building, all by myself, couldn't get help. And sometimes when you go into the basement and you know you can't get help for certain reasons, I can't expose them, the reasons why.
Yeah, I know, I know what he's talking about.
But seeing an entity like staring at you.
Are you kidding me? We just lost the light.
Yes, we did.
We just lost the light, and I just put a new battery in the light, so...
They're draining our
batteries. Go get it. Go get the light.
Mr. Ben, if I pay for your ticket... Okay, well, let me finish my other one. The location that really got to me... This is hard to tell you the truth, because I really don't get scared that often. But when I do, I guess Okay, when Eric got knocked out by something demonic... Or another entity. Eric got knocked out. My adrenaline was pumping. I was scared for him. Not really for me. I was just more scared for him. And I didn't show it in the episode, but my adrenaline was pumping and my hands was shaking and everything. That's probably, I guess,
the scariest. Also, at the old Washoe Club, I had an experience to where I was provoking the shit out of this this one entity that was talking crap to all these women and everything like that. So I started to provoke it. And then when I left that room from provoking, I felt like all the spirits in the damn building was pissed off at me and was surrounding me when I was trying to leave the building. And I kept my cool, because as an investigator, you're supposed to keep calm. You're not supposed to run away. So I just literally tried to talk to him, and then I walked out, like, all calmly. But that energy, feeling surrounded, is pretty creepy when you're by yourself. So
Jeff just put the 100 brick to that. Probably. Look, I mean, look. Remember when we put the battery in? I checked it. It had all the way up to full.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I don't know. I don't understand it. Okay, let's see what else. Is there a place that... Ah, here we go. Which one would you answer? Was it this one?
If there's a place you would not investigate due to certain reasons.
That's
a good question.
Oh, that's a good question right there. That's a very good question.
I don't think I would do... What's the name of that factory? Shit. There's this one factory. I'm trying to remember the name. Well, let's just say there's big holes in the factory where you could fall through. I'm not really a big fan on being the ghost there, so... I don't know if I would do it in pitch... Okay, maybe I would investigate it, but I wouldn't do it in pitch darkness because I don't want to fall.
Dude, what the hell? The light just came back on, people.
That's interesting.
Weird.
So pretty much the only reason why I wouldn't investigate a certain location is if it's too dangerous to my actual, you know, my human body. That's pretty much the only reasons. But yeah, other than that, I pretty much investigate any location.
I have no idea what it just did. It just went off again, so who knows?
Okay, Tim Shaw's watching now.
Hey, Tim! Timmy boy, I'm kind of squished right now, Tim. I'm like in between two people. Okay, here we go.
The basement.
I hate the basement of...
Of infirmary?
Alexis, I think everybody hates the basement of the infirmary, but it is the most haunted location, or part of the building, I would say.
Part of the building, yeah.
Yeah, it's the most haunted location in the building. Look at that. Tim Shaw, you guys rock. Thank you, Tim.
Thank you.
You rock, Tim. We love you. We can't wait to see you again. Hopefully, I'll see you sooner than later. Okay. Your house haunted for... Yeah. The light went on and went back off.
You know...
I don't know.
What could be changed into a good question?
What?
Like having personal experiences at home because of your investigation.
Oh, dude, yeah. Okay, why don't just talk about that anyway?
Sure.
Go ahead, you first.
Well... I've had multiple experiences at home. When I started investigating, a year into my investigating, I was attacked once when I was sleeping. And during that attack, it actually stopped my heart. I'm not going to really go into detail of what happened in my dream that led up to it, and it didn't feel like a dream. It felt like it was an out-of-body experience. But I was attacked, and I felt my heart stop. And then there was an entity that literally flew right into my face, a shadow person, and it was a woman, and then I just felt my heart stop. That was the scariest moment of my life. It wasn't during an investigation, it was at my own house, and it was like it was a warning or something. But when it comes to me, I have to know the answers of the unknown and figure it all out, so it doesn't stop me because I want to learn more and more. So that's the main reason why I didn't quit after that experience when most people would, because I need to solve the answers.
Oh, by the way, we're not sure if Matt's phone's gonna die. It just gave him the low battery warning.
Yeah.
So if it dies, I am so sorry.
Okay. Go if it dies, go over to Marcus's or Jennifer's, and then you'll be able to see it.
Yeah, hold on. I'm gonna go to one question here. Would you consider investigating in Florida? We have a list of haunted places. Okay. There's only one answer to this, and it's the simple answer. Would we investigate in Florida? Yes.
Why not? Like, the question should have been, why wouldn't we?
Yeah. Well, what location? No, yes, we would. We would have, we want to. There's locations in Florida we want to investigate. There's locations all over the world we want to investigate.
Yeah, like, there's not one, like, location I don't want to investigate if it's very active. If it's very active, I want to investigate it. If it's not, then I just, won't be as interested, but if I it's for free, then yes, I would investigate
it. Now we have the Goozes here. We got Corey.
The Goose.
I hate the damn basement, of course. Oozies. Okay, here we go. We got... Oh, he's... Look, he went from here to here. He's transporting. He's
God. He's going from Jennifer to Marcus. Is it my turn now?
Yeah.
Come on over to the Pioneer Saloon. Yeah, okay. That's actually a location I want to investigate.
Will we get it for free?
Yeah, if it's for free.
If it's for free, we will come. We will drive there.
Yes.
As everyone to say, the basement in Randolph County Infirmary, the most haunted spot in the building. You'll be the tour guide. I like that.
I was there for 3 nights, and I could say that was probably the most active.
I was there. I was there for like, I don't know how many days I was
and
there.
And the second floor also.
I experienced a full-bodied apparition at Randolph County Infirmary.
In Western New York.
Oh, okay. Hold up. Which building are we talking about? I think I know, Tim, what building you're talking about. Which building is it?
It's on mine now. You asked for it.
Oh!
Yes, I did.
Okay, is it the house I'm thinking of that you're on? If it is, you know which one it is, right?
Well, when it says Western, I don't know if it's in Western area, is it?
I think I know, and yes, Tim?
Bethany, New York.
Yeah, Tim, there's no other way to put this if it's the location I think you're talking about, and that's exactly what I knew it was.
Hinsdale for
yes!
location.
Yes! Yes!
Location,
yes! 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 We will come to there next year. I'm planning.
Rolling Hills is the one I actually talked to the woman. Rolling Hills, I talked to the woman. She doesn't want her history exposed or anything like that for some weird reason. It's a big deal in the paranormal field to know the history and share the history. We need to make the connections. And this person that owns the Rolling Hills Asylum does not want to give the history out. So I couldn't do my Man vs. Paranormal documentary there because of that, because I need all the details and expose it all. And she's not letting that happen. So I'm probably going to go there for a paranormal research unit / paranormal films investigation by ourselves. But it won't be for a documentary because she wouldn't approve it. So, yeah, that's what I can say about Rolling Hills Asylum.
Okay, here's one from Corey. Have you been to Bobby Mackey's? Yes and no. I have literally been on the property. I've just never gone into it. Again, I'll eventually get there. We will go. Should I give them the details for next year? I might as well.
Sure.
Just one location.
Sure.
One location. It's probably going to be the first location next year. It's in Newcastle, Pennsylvania. And the funny thing is, Resident Undead just did an episode on it. We're probably going to Hillview. That's the location we are planning for the season opener next year, and it's going to be bigger, better than we've ever done before. I think it's going to be bigger and better than you've ever done.
Yeah,
we're going to hit it hard, as usual. Hold on. We're just going to go... Yeah, Hillview, it's time to go there. I want to go, damn. And Angie, it's time. We got something special planned for you. And everybody I know, I want to let you know if certain people we are picking out to come investigate with us, because we know you guys, we want to work with you, we love you, we love everybody, but there's certain people I want to come out and investigate with. This is just, I'm just getting crammed. Jesus Christ. This is not cool.
So yeah, any more questions? There's so many that we got. Now we just want a little bit more to answer for you guys. Anything
yes,
at all.
Yes, there is room for ASL. There is definitely room
there
for
is.
It.
There is. There is room.
Yes. What are you putting
me,
in?
Me.
Yes, Tim.
What's the question?
Tim.
Something big. Something
out of this world. Ask anything.
We're waiting.
Yes, you are included, Corey. Don't worry. We go down the line, and I'm going to tell them how we pick people.
Okay.
We pick people based on a location that we think that they'd be incredible at. Everyone has a general aspect that we love. It's from people that we've met, to people that we're getting to know over Facebook, to people, you know, that we're just meeting, on the, you know, wherever. If we think you have something special, you're coming. You will be in an episode. You'll investigate. You'll get your own time on the investigation with us. We've done it with everybody. And, look, we got Dale jumping.
Dale.
But... we pick people because we want them to experience everything that we experience. We want them to see what we do. We want them to enjoy themselves. We want them to just go in, run in, and do it. It's face your fear, basically.
Yeah, Tim Shaw's like, do we need to wear underwear during our investigation?
Do we ever wear underwear
at the investigation?
Go ahead, answer that question.
No. You don't have to, but it's recommended.
So wait. Are you telling me that you freeball it, or are you doing
wearing pants? He goes commando. That's what Tim does.
Tim, that was freaking awesome. I love that question.
He goes to commando in a skirt.
Yeah, Jeff, I already talked to you about Hillview. You're in.
Pick me.
Oh, what does it say?
What's the next question?
He wants somebody. Okay, Lily. If we have some room, we will bring you along. We'll have Jen. We'll have you. Oh.
Tim Shaw would be in a kilt.
I know. Yes!
Commando style.
Yes!
That's the true Scottish.
Okay, hold on. Idea just popped in my head. We can have them do dueling deaf psychics, I guess. I don't know.
Hmm. Florida.
Says in Florida?
Oh,
okay. Yeah, she can come, and what we can do is we can put her to a test. Next year.
We already have a lot of people on the team total.
Yeah. They're just special guests. But like, we'll have you guys sit back till we need you. We're gonna give you when we bring guests in, we give them a quarantine. A very scary situation for a lot of people. You know that, because people get scared when they're alone. And I just like squished. I gotta do this. We'll put you in a very situation by yourself. We'll watch you the entire time you're there. We'll make contact with you.
That's a good question.
But, yeah, we invite people in.
Yeah, here, I have another question from Tim Shaw. What kind of ITC research do we do? Well, right now, I only use the SB7. I want to buy a lot more, but a lot of it's custom. They're all, like, custom-made from other investigators.
Yeah.
I would like to get into that, but a lot of the good ones are all custom-made. So I use this SB7, SB11, a ghost box once, and so I want to use a lot more, though.
I'm going to go check the mic, make sure that's still working.
Okay.
Yeah, for a second.
Like, Rocky, he just joined, and he knows...
I need to go look at the camera.
Rocky knows some ITC research. He's created his own device called the Banshee. And
sweaty.
And once he ever produces that, or I don't know if he will, I would like to try it out. It was pretty cool when we used it.
Oh, I'm sweaty.
No, it's just me, guys.
You know what? We're going to change the...
How many more... minutes are on that.
Hold on. It's going 3, 2, 1, 0. Hold on. 20 minutes. So now I need to hit record.
All right. Let me know. Okay. When
we are recording.
Guests, is it usually... Do they usually soil themselves?
Dude.
No, not literally, but there's some times where they look like it.
My camera... shut itself off. This is going to be interesting. Let's see. I want to make sure. Tell them I'm making sure it's recording.
Yeah, right now Marcus is just busy with the camera work, which is important because we're putting this on YouTube. Ulysses is back for another question, I believe. Have you guys heard of Casa de la... I'm horrible with Spanish. I can't say
it.
Brajas. And if you know, would you want to do an investigation there? Would you like to do an investigation there? Okay. Sorry, I had to correct you. Would I like to do an investigation there? Like I said, any location that's haunted, I would love to do any. Your house is totally haunted.
My house? Is it my house?
Which one? His or mine? No, it's not really haunted, I guess. It's more like I have entities that come to visit every once in a while. Yeah. Hauntings are more active and happens a lot more. Mine is like every once in a while. And when I started investigating, when I first started investigating, it was so much more active when I first started. And I had a lot of stuff following me home. But when I got more experience,
we're gonna have to move you over here,
stopped following me home a bit. Mainly for the negative ones, they stopped following me home, which is good. But what happened with Revenant Acres, two nights before we did Revenant Acres, I did have a weird experience. So, yeah, that's pretty much...
You know what? I'm just so squished right now.
Here we go.
So what questions did I miss? I had to, like, go set stuff up.
Okay.
What?
You guys, are you guys coming to investigate September 17th, October 29th? You are all invited. We're invited. Is it free?
Oh, dude, thank you for the phone. We got you. We will definitely hit you up, Corey. Again, September 17th, we're out of state. I am just so freaking squished right now. I'm just, like, claustrophobic.
Guys, I just want to let you know, this trailer that we made for Revenant Acres is pretty amazing.
It's awesome.
And it's probably one of my best trailers I've made so far. And what you're going to see there, are you guys interested in Bigfoot or Crypto? Actually, for cryptozoology, I am I'm kind of interested, but I'm mostly into the ghosts and other entities, plus aliens. Those are the two things I'm more interested in, and the stuff I believe in more, because there's so much evidence towards those two, way more than the cryptozoology stuff. There's so that just also like Bigfoot, like if they found a big giant new animal, like we already find a lot of new animals, so I don't really care if we find another one, you know what I mean? So it's not really that big of a deal, unless it's actually a missing link, and then that'll be a very big deal. But so far, it's not really something that interests me as much. It's mostly the ghosts, the demons, the angels, all those little and all those type of entities, plus aliens. I do believe in.
Okay.
So yeah.
Hold on, I have a question here from Heather. Do any of you cleanse your home regularly? Here's the funny thing, my neighbors do it all the time, so we get the. Your battery's gonna die.
Everyone, go to Marcus's channel. My battery's at 5%, so I want to say goodbye on this side, and just go to Marcus's live feed if you want to finish this whole Q&A.
Okay. It was a question of a cleanse. Our neighbors do it all the time because of me. They hate me. So yeah. So I get the cleansing back over here, and honestly, you know, I say prayers before I leave. I make sure nothing comes home with me. So that's what I do to protect us now. And I can tell you right now, we have a haunted apartment because the bricks that we got, one is from Jeff Fent. He gave me to me from the Emmett house that burnt down. And I have a brick from the old Licking County Jail that's starting to produce things. So, yeah, it's haunted. Okay, here we go. Nice, I know. Dale, I'll let you know. I'll message you about what's going on. And Dwayne, we will be there on next Saturday.
I know. Revenant Acres, missed that. I'm owner. You're an owner of Revenant Acres? Well, guess what? We got some good evidence, and I think you're gonna like it. The trailer will be released tonight after this whole thing's done. This whole Q&A thing is done. The trailer will be released. I'm 98% done with it. You get to see what has happened. And what has happened is pretty intriguing, I think.
Now we have Dwayne jumping, so hey. So, yeah, this okay, I'm gonna tell everybody, Revenant Acres was everything that I expected and more, honestly.
It kind of changed a little bit of his beliefs. He's kind of like tipping over which side he believes in now.
Yeah.
So that's what this episode has done to him. So it's interesting and it's going to be intriguing.
I'm sorry, I just bumped the table. Okay, what is this? When are you getting your butt up to Wisconsin? Oh, Lord. I know. Okay. I became a fan of Art. Art is just such a cool dude. Soon, my friend, soon. I don't know if it's going to be within the next year, but soon. We'll be up there because I know you have a buttload of investigations, a buttload of places you want us to go to. We'll be up there. Just give us some time, pal. We're planning out season 3 right now. I've actually started to map out the locations and where we want to go. As of right now, I think we're going to do about 4, okay, maybe 5 next year because of the money cost. It's going to cost a lot more money. And I'm going to give you a hint at the second episode, probably.
I'll be doing a lot of small investigations, too, yeah, that don't cost, like, really anything. Yeah.
Okay. Art, here's our probably second location. You ready for it? It's in West... Wait, no, that's the other one. It's in Radford, Virginia, if that gives you a clue. You know, it's a. It was a. What is it? What is it? St. Albans.
No video stopped.
Oh, is. Well, just exit out and come back in, but he can't, yeah, hear us right now because his video stopped.
What time? What time for what? I don't know what time you're talking. Oh, the trailer. If it's the trailer will be out. Tonight sometime.
Sometime tonight, like right after this video is done, I'm going back to it. It's 98% finished, so it's going to be pretty quick, like probably 20 more minutes of tweaking it.
Yes.
And then it'll be done.
Yes, St. Albans. Yes, St. Albans is going to be an amazing location. We haven't done it yet. This will be the first time. Yes, exactly what I thought she was about. Yeah, so we don't know what time yet. Whenever it gets loaded. So
just letting you know that it took like about 5 hours
to edit 1 minute.
Of editing a 1 minute and 16 second trailer.
Yeah.
1 minute, 16 second trailer took 5 hours to edit because it's a lot of details I had to do and color correcting and everything like that.
Okay, you, along with that, when we get on, look, he's jumping now. He just jumped.
Which one, Sean?
Sean just jumped.
Oh my God.
He's a jumper. All right.
Through live feeds of the same one.
We are planning. We started to talk to the Monroe House to go back there. And
that's,
I think,
I really
we're probably going to go there this next coming year for season 3. Either we start filming season 3 this winter, mm-hmm, or we start early next year. We are not going to try to take as many breaks this year between filming, because what happens is you take too many breaks. The edit takes forever. The episode takes forever to put out. So, yeah, we're trying not to take as much break this year. I think we just need to keep going and rolling with it, because I'll be working with him.
That's the lifestyle.
And I'll be doing stuff. So it's not going to stop next year. I was really busy this year with looking for a new location, and I think I found one for Adam. So hopefully we get that up here soon.
Okay.
I'm hoping. I can't talk about that because it's very privileged information, but let me put it this way. There is a location in Ohio that we want, and I can't tell you where, though, and it's awesome.
Have you ever been to Ohio? He lives in Ohio.
Yeah, I live here. He's here right now. He's in Ohio right now.
I'm in Ohio right now.
Yes. Okay, here it is.
We are all scrambling to get your...
I know. What's up with that, Ray? Jesus Christ. Okay. Has anyone else left RCI and got to their car to find a... Oh, my God. Okay.
Find a what?
Oh, God. That was freaky. He found a dead bird on his car.
You know what? The RCI, since I've been there for 3 nights, I'm just going to tell you there's tons of dead birds on that property.
Yeah. This is from Sean, by the way. When we were getting ready to leave, mm-hmm, there's a dead baby bird just on his car. Talk about not good luck. He actually cleansed his entire car because of it. And cleansed himself and cleansed the whole... So, yeah, I haven't seen that, but I've seen a ton of dead birds there. There's just something about the energy there that you just find them everywhere. We don't understand it. Ohio is the most haunted state. Doesn't surprise me, Goose.
Waverly, Ohio.
Well done. Ah, so he would have been near the Emmett House. You would have been near the Emmett House that burnt down.
Is it completely burned down?
Yeah.
Damn.
And what happened was it flashed when they put it out. It froze, and yeah, it's not good.
Please out, guys. Birthday cake time. Peace out, guys. I thought I said please for a second. Peace out. Okay. Happy birthday to whoever it is. Is it Goose's birthday?
I'm waiting for this light to go out. Seriously.
And if it does...
We're in complete pitch black.
What we usually do.
Yeah. Yeah, so we have one light go out. Let's just see if it's going to go.
Oh my gosh, now it's on now. Come on. Really? Well then.
I mean, look at that. Full brightness. I have no idea what happened. Luckily we got two of these going. No, they just turned it off. They just turned it off. Nah. So yeah, so look. So look, remember how this went out? Look. It's on now. See? I mean, I can... Did it just go out?
Okay, hold on.
There it is.
Let's try and debunk this. It's at one right now, so...
But we had it at four. That's
probably,
weird.
Probably expected.
Yeah. Son of a bitch, right?
Debunking.
Debunking, but...
What paranormal investigators do or should do. Let's just say that.
See, look. Yeah.
One bar on that thing, so it's just going out normally.
Is that your home haunted?
Is that your home?
We have the bricks.
What the beep?
Well,
Emmett, we have a hem. Okay, Lily.
Nope. Watch.
Lily, we have two haunted bricks.
Get a fat. Three. Bubble trap. Three. Hammerhead. How do you three? Double fry. How do you?
Endenburg Manor tomorrow, bros. Fourth visit. Gotta try if you can. Hey!
Hey, who is it?
Polly.
You're too good at that.
I know. I think I am.
You should be ashamed.
Why? What's wrong with being gay?
I'm nothing.
I'm not gay, but seriously.
You're too good at that. We're just having some fun.
What's your favorite place to visit so far? Well, damn, that's a hard one. I really like Virginia City, Nevada. That location it has a cool feel to it, and it has a lot of history to it. And so I think Virginia City so far is probably my favorite.
So what do we have? What is my favorite place to visit so far? I don't know. I don't have a favorite. Honestly, they each have something good about it. Honestly, all the way from the location that we go to the people we meet, to the wherever we stay. We're getting some loving on here.
Yes, we are. Lots of likes.
What?
Lots of love.
I don't know.
Favorite place to visit. Yeah.
I don't know what it is. I mean, there's so many that we go to.
Yeah, there is, and I like different places for different reasons. That's all I'm going to say. Like, there's, like, asylums I like more. Is my favorite locations to investigate are asylums. Asylums and jails are my favorite places. But when it comes to, like, the area surrounded by, I would say Virginia City is my favorite because it's a quiet town, and the whole feel of the town, it feels pretty cool. I don't know. It's weird to describe it.
You know what? I'm going to have to go with one of my favorite cities is Saddamsville.
Sometimes.
And Cincinnati.
The one where he got scared shitless.
Scared shitless, yeah. But the city itself is amazing. It's old. Cincinnati's awesome.
I want to go to Post Town Elementary. Oh. I do want to. Jeff. Jeff Fent asked that question.
You okay?
It was,
Oh, yeah.
What's your favorite place? Oh, that's the same question. What is your craziest experience, whether or not... whether on or off camera?
Oh, see, I like this question because we experience a lot of things off
camera
that you don't see.
70% of it is on camera. The other 30% isn't.
And usually the stuff that's not on camera is the big stuff that happens. And it's always that way.
At least from my experience.
From my experience, too. Randolph County Infirmary is an example, right?
Yes. Randolph County Infirmary, when I was there for 3 nights, the second night, it was almost nighttime, I saw a full body shadow person at the end of the hallway to the left, first floor, down that hallway. It just appeared out of thin air, just staring at me, like staring me down for like 6 to 7 seconds, and then the shadow person just dissipated. Actually, dematerialized. It was pretty interesting. I didn't have a camera on me at the time it happened, though, because I was going to start my investigation around like 7 or something like that, or 8. I forgot what time. It was a little while ago. But that was pretty cool. And we're getting off a little bit. Damn, I can't speak right now.
Oh, nice. The crazy experience I had was at Randolph County Infirmary when we heard the door slam. You remember that?
Yeah, that was a really cool experience, but not the craziest. But definitely a really awesome experience.
We thought Chris had come in.
Uh huh.
And we are chased right, trying to chase Chris down, and Chris is nowhere to be found. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
There's him.
I got this. Saddamsville Rectory.
There's one question from Jeff. Wait, are you done?
You're done, right?
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Are we brothers? Well, we kind of act like it, but no, we're not.
I don't like this dude at all.
Yeah,
I hate him.
Now we just act like we're brothers more, damn it.
Damn it! I'm out! Stop, I'm going! I don't like him.
My brother is actually Cody Benton. Shout out.
He's awesome. We are all losing our batteries, honestly. We're all going to die.
We're still good, though. We're still good.
We're still good. We only have, like, a couple more minutes left, okay, guys? Because it's almost 8 o'clock. We want to finish this up then so we can get this trailer out.
You want to see... Here, this is funny because, actually, my brother doesn't look really that much like me. And everyone's... Two people, apparently, I look like since I moved to Indiana. And people keep saying that. But I want to show you what my brother looks like. He doesn't look anything like me, but he's a cool guy.
No, he doesn't. Holy crap.
That's my brother. And he is awesome. So, yep. Just so if you guys are wondering.
What is the scariest... Okay, so which one were we at? What is the craziest experience? Okay, what is the scariest thing that ever tried... I'm too squished. I'm like, eh.
What is the scariest thing you have tried to gain interaction on an investigation? Scariest experience of trying to gain an interaction?
That's what I'm thinking. I don't know what mine was. Mine was dressing as a priest at Saddamsville. I dressed like a priest at Saddamsville to try to get attention. And it worked.
And too well. Why was it scarier, though?
Because it was reacting to the priest costume.
Interesting.
Yeah. Pretty scary. Well,
for me, like, when you know that you're provoking a negative entity, and you know it could have precautions, I guess that's scary, trying to get its attention, and sometimes it works. Mackie Mansion is a perfect example of the Mackie Mansion episode I did. Provoking did work for that investigation. Sometimes provoking is okay, sometimes it's not, because it depends on the entity. Well, for that location, I felt like we would get probably more activity from provoking, and it did. It worked, and I'm gonna say that's what is scarier is when you know an entity could probably harm you, and you provoke it. But it's what we do to get answers and to, you know, prove they are there.
Hey Jeff, we love you. Thank you. We love you. We love you. We love you. See you soon, bro. We're actually about to get off now too. We've been going on for like an hour.
Yep. But we need to stay a little bit longer because we were 2 minutes late or 3 minutes, something like that.
Whatever. So we have to get off because we want to get this out to you guys so you can see this trailer. It's amazing. Yes.
After this, you guys have to watch this trailer because I spent damn 5 hours on this trailer. So you guys better watch it.
You better watch it. You better watch it.
This is my editing.
You better watch it.
This is all my editing style. I'd like to do a little bit of a creepier type effect. Yeah.
She's saying I love you. I think she wants to get off. She's like, I love you to everybody.
Damn.
No,
you don't like her fans?
Damn it. No, seriously, guys, thank you for watching. We're going to get off here. We'll do another question and answer later on.
Yeah.
For you guys. And this is going to be at the end of the season. We want you to ask questions about all the episodes, what you can. Just ask us anything.
Actually,
we're all
good. I have a good idea. When we get off of this, I'm going to finish this little trailer, and then... After it's been out and everyone's watched it, we'll do another live feed. And
oh, yeah.
If anyone has little questions of that, we'll, it'll be probably a little bit later time. It's 7:59 right now. So, yeah. Like, a little bit later, probably, like, almost 9 o'clock, we'll probably do another Q&A after everyone's watched.
We're going to have to put our phones on the charger, too.
Yeah, that, too.
So, we love you guys. Stay tuned. We'll be back later. Love you. See you later. Let's try to finish these off. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Love you.